Hoover 28, a chicken in every pot. How's that working out, Herbie?
Sonny, you're just in time.
How've you been, Emmett? I know I haven't seen you in a couple of months.
I'm great, and I owe it all to you.
Really?
Yes. That argument I had with my father during our jet drill experiment gave me the incentive to finally quit that dreary court job. I've committed myself full-time to a life of science.
So, thanks for watching Einstein while I've been away.
It's been a pleasure. He's proven to be a surprisingly willing test subject. It's almost as if he's been working with me for years.
More like decades. What's the story with the little car and all this equipment?
Einstein and I are conducting a few experiments with this one-quarter scale model to work out a few hitches in my planned demonstration at the Hill Valley Expo in a couple of months.
A radio-controlled car?
No. Well, yes, but it'll be so much more than that. It will amaze the world. Aha! Got it!
Got what?
I'll show you. Ready to go, Einstein? Watch this! When this baby hits 23 miles per hour, you're gonna see some serious cow flop.
Einstein!
No!
Get him out of there!
Not to worry. I've got a fail-safe eject mechanism around here someplace. See? Nothing to worry about.
Nothing. I'll go see if I can find something to help. Or someone. Edna!
What?
Hey, I got a hot lead for you.
Oh? What is it?
Young scientist strands dog on courthouse roof.
What?
Look over there.
Oh, for goodness sake. Mr. Brown!
Please, Miss Strickland, not now. Can't you see I've got a rather delicate situation on my hands at the moment? My trial run...
Trial run? Public hazard, I call it. And I'm sure my editor will agree. And really, I ask you...
Don't you lecture me.
Come here, Heine! Come on, boy. Fire escapes this way.
How can I be a member of...
Looks like I'm gonna need more help.
Stand up for the safety of all. Well then, if you refuse to give me a statement, I just won't tell your side of the story.
Arrgh! Damned exasperating woman. It's okay, Heine. The bad lady's gone. Come on down.
Hey, Doc, I could use a little help.
What's the problem?
Why didn't you tell me I'd run into your younger self tonight?
Because I don't remember being out here tonight. Clearly, your interactions with my younger self 2 months ago have slightly altered my personal timeline. I never have the nerve to perform public experiments like he's doing. No matter, those experiments will be forgotten once I've seen Frankenstein.
Frankenstein?
Yes. Right now, my younger self is fiddling around out there with rocket propulsion systems for his demonstration at the expo.
The thing that'll kick off your scientific career.
Exactly. Now, the rockets are a horrible idea, and I'll soon realize that they'll never work. But eventually, I'll wander into that movie theater and see Frankenstein and clear my mind. I've kept the ticket stub from that movie in my wallet ever since. See?
Why?
Because it's during this movie that I'll have the inspiration for my breakthrough at the expo.
It doesn't have anything to do with reanimating the dead, does it?
Not the way you're thinking, no. But during that famous scene when Colin Clive turned the wheel that raised that shrouded figure into the tower and that bolt of lightning struck, well, let's just say more than one brain was reanimated that night.
Emmett's not having much luck getting Einstein off the courthouse.
I'm not surprised. Ein is a smart dog, but heights give him the willies.
What can we do?
I've got it.
What?
Just get my younger self distracted, and I'll handle the rest.
Okay, I better get back to fixing history.
Be careful, Marty.
Edna!
What?
Hey, I got a hot lead for you.
Oh? What is it?
There's a new angle on the Emmett Brown story.
What is it?
It's even worse than you thought.
Oh, Lord. Mr. Brown!
What is it now, Mr. Brown?
I could ask the same question of you, Miss Strickland.
This scientific enterprise of yours represents a clear and present danger to public
safety.
You
know what represents a clear and present danger to public safety? Your singing voice.
There's no need to get personal, Mr. Brown.
Believe me, I have no intention of getting personal with you.
I'm relieved to hear it. Flying cars, of all the ridiculous juvenile
notions.
You
mock me, but just imagine, a world in which traffic jams and car crashes are a thing of the past.
Well, I might be more inclined to listen to you if your maiden voyage hadn't ended in a crash on one roof and a stranded dog on another.
I'm working on getting him down. Einie, how'd you get down? Clever dog.
Well, fortune favors you tonight, but I warn you to be more careful in the future.
Now, how to get that rocket car back down?
Testing, testing. Sibilance.
Hey, quit playing with my equipment.
Sorry. Hey, boy, how you doing? Good dog. Edna!
What?
You know, you seem pretty, passionate about Emmett. I mean, considering that you don't really like him and all.
I'm passionate about everything, Mr. Crockett. Even my loathing.
See ya.
Keep fighting the good fight.
Hey, boy, take a whiff of this. Gotta love that nose.
Officer, but I've got to go to the pictures once in a while.
Hello, Arthur.
Officer?
I'll take it from here.
But...
We can talk at the Majestic, away from prying eyes.
Yeah, Einstein, you done good. Hey, Doc, I could use a little help.
What's the problem?
Is Artie still here?
He's in the bathroom.
Hey, Artie, open up. You've got a gangster to bring down.
Is it time for me to meet this Sylvia?
No, it's time for you to meet Trixie.
Trixie says she's got something that might be able to send Kid up the river, but that you're the only one she trusts to check it out.
Me? What is she... Oh, I know what she's done. Clever.
Care to let us in on the secret?
Sorry, guys, but if Trixie's keeping it a secret, then so am I.
That's all well and good, Mr. McFly, but if you and Trixie are going to collaborate on this evidence, we'll need to arrange a rendezvous.
Well, Trixie's chained to Kid's speakeasy.
So we'll have to bring Arthur to Trixie.
Uh-uh. No way am I getting anywhere near that place again. I don't know how you talked me into this.
Just stay back here in the shadows and don't come out until you see Trixie.
You're sure I'll be safe here?
Perfectly safe. We'd never make you take any unnecessary...
Sagan. Where's Kid?
Don't worry.
Is Trixie on her way?
Welcome back, sir.
What's it gonna take to get Trixie to squeal on Kid? Trixie?
Yeah?
Guess who's waiting in the alley to talk with you?
Huddy?
The one and only. It wasn't easy to track him down. I had
to... Have a foamy cue ball. I'm taking a smoke break.
Atta girl.
Hey, you!
Huh?
Yeah, jerk. I saw you making eyes at my Eunice.
Sorry, pal. I don't have time for a fight.
Why, you? I'll never get to Carnegie Hall at this rate. All right, fella. I think you're done for the night. Hey, where do you think you're going?
Me?
Yeah, you. What do you know about this?
Nothing.
Trixie?
Breaks over, cue ball.
Babe.
What was that? Trixie?
Yeah?
What happened in the alley with Arthur?
I don't want to talk about it.
Break a leg out there.
Thanks.
Artie?
You missed a hell of a party, buddy.
Kid, well, what happened?
Oh, you're gonna love this. So, I'm hanging out in the club when all of a sudden I get an urge to drain the lizard, right? I come out into the alley, and who do I see? None other than that scrawny, subpoena-answering rat, Artie McFly. And get this! The little worm's whispering away all conquistadorial-like with my Trixie!
Oh, no.
Naturally, I pull out Kid Jr. and prepare to put a couple bullets in McFly's head, which causes Artie's nose to start bleeding because he's a big wuss. And then...
What?
Trixie literally gets down on the knees and begs me to let him live!
Huh?
Seriously, down on the knees crying and begging for McFly's life!
So, what did you do?
What could I do? I fired 2 shots in the air and told Artie to take a hike.
Huh, that was merciful.
Hey, I got plenty of mercy. Besides, now Trixie owes me big time. And Kid Tannen always collects on his debts. Always.
Hey, Doc, I could use a little help.
What's the problem?
The rendezvous was a bust, Doc. Tannen caught Artie and Trixie in the alley. Trixie begged for his life, but now she's acting weird.
You better talk to her before she does something rash.
Why are Tannens always such jerks, anyway?
It's hard to say. Rogue Neanderthal genes in their DNA, perhaps.
Okay, I better get back to fixing history.
Be careful, Marty.
Emmett.
No, time for chit-chat. I've got a rocket car to recover.
Emmett! You get down from there before you hurt yourself!
Hurt myself? You're far too cautious, Miss Strickland.
Are you sure that's safe?
Of course it's not safe. That soup kitchen he's climbing is owned by gangsters!
Stop being such chickens! See? Safe as houses!
Don't blame me if you end up dead! Oh, that man is so infuriating!
Welcome back, sir. Boss?
Do you mind? I'm trying to have a good time here.
I think you'll want to see this.
Are you crazy? Bringing a stick of dynamite into my club?
That's just it, boss. It's all over the place. I think our speakeasy arsonist is getting ready to strike again.
What's it gonna take to get Trixie to squeal on Kid? Trixie?
Yeah?
About Artie McFly.
What about him? Have you heard from him? Is he okay?
Oh, yeah, he's okay.
Are you sure?
Believe me, if he wasn't okay, I'd be the first to know. I talked to Kid.
Oh?
He told me about Artie.
Oh.
It was awesome of you to plead for his life.
And it was awesome of Kid to spare it. So you see why I gotta get rid of all the dirt I got on Kid. As long as he's loyal to me, I gotta stay loyal to him.
Okay, so Kid spared Artie's life, but that doesn't make him a saint.
Believe me, no one knows that better than me. But if Kid can let Artie off the hook, I guess I can let him off the hook. Know what I mean?
About Artie McFly.
What about him? Have you heard from him? Is he okay?
Oh, yeah, he's okay.
Are you sure?
Believe me, if he wasn't okay, I'd be the first to know. About Artie McFly.
What about him? Have you heard from him? Is he okay?
I think something bad might have happened to him.
What? You mean Kid went back on his promise?
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, no! Oh, poor Artie! Poor, sweet little Artie!
I know.
That rattlesnake Kid! He can't get away with this!
You gonna turn over the evidence you got against him?
Am I ever! Just watch me! Wait a minute. What evidence do you have that Kid bumped Artie off?
It's just a hunch.
Keep your hunches for the racetrack. It ain't nice to get a girl all worked up over unsubstantiated rumors.
Break a leg out there.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Edna!
What?
How's that song going over?
Oh, if only I could convince a few of these night owls to stop and listen. Would you like to hear it?
Maybe later.
I'll be here all night.
See ya.
Keep fighting the good fight.
I guess that's Grandpa's nose blood.
Welcome back, sir.
What's it gonna take to get Trixie to squeal on Kid? Hey, bartender.
What'll it be?
So about this, portrait gallery of yours.
What about it?
What's it all about? Who are those guys?
The caricatures hanging along the Wall of Honor commemorate those who are no longer with us on account of having ticked off one Irving Kid Tannen.
They're the guys the kids killed?
Well, of course not. They're just a bunch of guys that Kid didn't particularly like and that at a later date turned up dead. It's a circumstantial coincidence. Yeah.
Do you know what happened to Trixie out there? She seems pretty freaked out.
You talk weird, you know that? But no, I don't know nothing about Trixie's emotional state. Kid doesn't pay me nearly enough to pour drinks and babysit his crazy girlfriends.
What are you drawing?
Another celebrity caricature.
You drew those?
Prohibition ain't gonna last forever, bub. I gotta have a skill I can fall back on when all this goes away.
I'll have a drink.
What's your poison?
Peps, on second thought, forget it.
Suit yourself.
Think you could do a caricature of me?
Sure. Presto!
That really doesn't look like me.
I didn't have much to work with.
So is your cold all better?
My cold?
Yeah, when I saw you a few hours ago, you were sneezing like crazy.
Mister, I ain't had a cold in over 2 months.
Oh yeah, right. Sorry. Wrong guy. So everyone on the Wall of Fame are enemies of Kid Tannen that have coincidentally been killed?
Enemies, rivals, guys who looked at Trixie the wrong way. Yeah.
Who are you working on now?
Boris Karloff. What do you think?
Not bad. So everyone on the Wall of Fame are enemies of Kid Tannen that have coincidentally been killed?
Enemies, rivals, guys who looked at Trixie the wrong way. Yeah.
What's it like working for Tannen?
You looking for a job?
No.
Then stop being so nosy.
Thanks for the talk.
Next time, order a drink. This ain't no library, you know.
You in?
Why not? Gonna put it all on red.
$29.
Ah! you think you could draw a picture of this guy?
Sure. Hey, that looks like that Artie McFly Fink.
I never noticed that before. Hey, can you give him a hat like Artie wears?
Voila!
Nice job.
Now, go tell them chumps at the New Yorker.
Sorry about this, Dad. Trixie?
Yeah?
I don't know how to tell you this, but I think you should check out the Wall of Fame.
Why? What is it? Artie! I don't believe it! We had a deal! Artie was supposed to be safe!
I don't know what to say.
Well, I do. Felony tax evasion.
What?
Before he died, Artie was teaching me about all sorts of stuff. Literature, history, accounting. And I made a big discovery while I was copying all of kids' books. This establishment ain't entirely on the up and up.
Really?
Oh, I knew about all the gangster stuff. That kind of thing you expect from tough guys like Hid. But when I found out he ain't been paying taxes on his speakeasy profits, well, cheating Uncle Sam is one step over the line. Once I turn this over to the police, they'll throw the book at him. This book! Hey, copper! What happened to my louse of an ex-boyfriend?
I don't know.
Rats. I told the chief we need a team of bloodhounds like they got over in Placerville. Yeah, but in the meantime...
All right, everyone. Party's over. Everyone out of the speakeasy.
Speakeasy? You're mistaken, officer. This is an ice cream parlor.
Nice try, you. Out!
Crockett, would the Valenti mob be willing to help, defuse this little situation?
Sure, no problem. I'll bring it up in the next, company meeting.
Hey, we ain't begging here. Kid just thought JJ might like a piece of the action, especially now that he's just caught the speakeasy arsonist.
Wait, you mean Doc?
Doc? You ain't with the Valenti gang at all, are you? What do you know about the arsonist?
Come on, you. Off to the station house.
Kid's gonna get you, rat. He's gonna get all of you.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's that. Thanks to Miss Trotter's evidence, the entire Hill Valley police force is out looking for Kid and his goons.
You don't understand. We've got to find him now. He's captured a friend of mine.
Who?
Never mind.
Don't worry. We've got the entire town square sealed off. If Tannen's within a mile of here, we'll find him eventually.
I don't think we have time for eventually. Hey, boy, how you doing? Good dog. Ew. Irving Kid Tannen. Guess he dropped this on his way out. It's empty. Figures. Hey, Einie, get your nose over here. All right. I really don't think Tannen and Doc are with Herbert Hoover, Einie. Okay, I'll check it out. A button. It's empty, so what's the point? All right, Doc, here I come.
Crockett? What are you doing here?
Never
mind. Come here and help me get rid of this stinking arsonist.
Edna?
I caught her planting dynamite while he was clearing out the soup kitchen. Guess Sagan was innocent after all.
I was researching a story, you ignoramus!
Tell it to St. Peter, sister.
Hey, what's all this?
Parker?
Tannen, you're under arrest.
Get him, Sacramento boy.
I can't do that, kid.
What? Oh, I get it.
Why don't you let go of Miss Strickland and call it a night?
Hey, look over there!
Watch out!
Give it up, Tannen. The alley's blocked off and so are the roads out of town. It's over.
Over? Nothing is over until Kid Tannen says it's over!
I don't think he wants to smoke right now.
Me?
I don't think so. The only thing I want to break this bottle on is one of those goons' heads. You want your flask back, Tannen? Come and get it! I don't think they'd be interested in my caricature.
No one messes with Kid Tannen!
He's not about to let me in.
Come on, kid. You know...
What should I do?
Do you have a gun?
Not a real one.
Beats me.
Want a light?
Maybe later.
Maybe not. I don't think he wants to smoke right now. Not sure what that...
Shooting at me? Are you shooting at me?
This is no time for word games. What should I do?
Beats me.
I can't reach them from over here.
I could do this all night, Parker!
He's not about to let me in.
Make it!
You want your flask back, Tannen? Come and get it! It's empty, so what's the point? Want your flask back, Tannen? Come and get it!
No one messes with Kid Tannen!
Come on, kid. You know how this'll end.
Yeah, with me dancing on your grave! Are you shooting at me? Are you shooting at me? Tannen, make like a tree and die, rat! Whoa!
Make it easier.
Bowling for Tannen.
No!
What should I do?
Beats me!
A trail of explosive booze leading right into the garage. Heavy. Sweet.
Come on, kid. You know how this'll end.
Yeah, with me dancing on your grave. Are you shooting at me? Are you shooting at me? I could do this all night, Parker!
Make it easy on yourself, Tannen!
Tannens never make things easy!
I can't get to the car from here.
Hey, kid! Eat lead, phony!
Hey, moron!
Moron, this!
Yo, Tannen!
Make like a tree and die, rat!
Atta girl.
Hey, kid! Eat lead, phony! No one messes with Kid Tannen!
So...
I'm afraid I'm finding it difficult to concentrate with all the bullets flying around my head, Mr. Crockett!
Right!
Come on, kid. You know how this'll end.
Yeah, with me dancing on your grave! Are you shooting at me? Are you shooting at me? Hey, kid! That ain't a real gun!
Oh, right. I forgot. I better just get rid of it then.
Oh, crap.
Hey, he's getting away!
Oh, no.
Yes.
No.
There! Good as new.
Oh, look.
Tannen?
The judge's son. All right, Parker. I want a getaway car and a clear road to Nevada, or the brown kid gets it.
Doc.
Marty.
Doc?
Yes, it's me.
I'm talking to you through the radio apparatus my younger self has installed in the rocket car. What's going on up there?
It's not good, Doc. Trixie and Parker did their part, but now Kid's holding you hostage.
Great Scott!
No kidding.
Try to get Kid in the car. Once he's inside, give me a signal, and I'll do the rest.
How am I...
You! Emmett! You're the cause of all of this, ain't you? Should have known. I mean, Sonny Crockett?
Yeah, well, what kind of gangster's named Irving?
No one makes a fool out of me, you backstabbing twerp!
I guess I'm no one then.
Tannen, I'm placing you under arrest for kidnapping, attempted murder, tax evasion, and smelling like a piece of crap.
Tax evasion?
Haven't you heard? The feds are practically drooling over Trixie's books.
Trixie?
That's what you get for killing Artie, you bastard!
What? I didn't...
Trixie?
Artie?
All right, Grandpa.
My poor car.
I believe I owe you an apology, Mr. Brown. Thanks to your ridiculous contraption, Hill Valley's most notorious criminal is finally headed to prison.
No apologies necessary, Miss Strickland. My rocket car may have accidentally saved the day, but only because it's a completely out-of-control failure. I need a new idea.
If you're willing to listen, I might have a few suggestions.
But first, I think we should take in a movie.
I'm all yours, Mr. Brown.
I think you'll like it. It's all about a brilliant scientist with an overabundance of hubris.
Whew. Come on, Einie. Let's go find Doc. Thanks for letting me fly the DeLorean, Doc. This thing's a blast.
Are you absolutely sure that everything's back to normal?
Totally. Kid's going to jail, Emmett's going to see Frankenstein, and there's no such thing as a Tannen crime family in 1986. And we remembered Einstein this time, too.
Hill Valley crime rate at all-time low.
Well, except for Grandpa necking with Trixie, I think we're ready to go back to 1986.
Do you feel yourself fading out of existence?
No.
Then as long as your father's still born in 7 years, I say, let your grandfather sow his oats.
Sowing oats? Is that what's going on with you and Edna?
What are you talking about?
Emmett and Edna. They're gonna go see Frankenstein together.
That's odd. Great Scott!
What?
Thank you. We've got to get back in. Something horrible. This could be disastrous.
Doc!
Where'd you go, Doc?
Relax! We've got everything under control.
Doc?
Martin McFly, age 18.
Okay, Doc, let's see what kind of nightmare alternate timeline I've landed in this time.
Father George, Mother Lorraine.
Hill Valley under Citizen Brown is not quite the contented town you were led to believe it was.
A re-education program? What the hell?
Please don't swear, Martin. It makes me uncomfortable.
Zero demerits, until this morning.
We're through, McFly. I'll never date such a square again.
My own girlfriend thinks I'm a square?
The obvious question, Mr. McFly, is... what happened to you?
Jesus Christ, Doc, what happened to you?